see some ID, pal.
AM 1610, KMPC Pondsburg.
The station that reaches the beaches and rocks the shores.
Hello, and welcome to the Mini Point Show, / radio show, if you're watching it on a radio and not YouTube. Which, most people, I don't know. But anyways, okay. I am Aiden Bird, and this is my buddy over here, Dilshan Rajan. Say hi.
Hi.
Okay. And we will be talking about fun mini point activities today. The first one, water activities.
Very fun. The second one is shooting sports.
And then food, because we all have to eat.
Yeah. And merit badges, because you need those to become an Eagle Scout.
Well, yeah. Okay. And then if we have time, then
we can add some
other stuff, which will be like bonus if we have time and our counselor lets us.
Yeah.
Okay. So, first, water activities. So, Dilshan, you talk about this.
Okay, well, there's some really cool water activities at Mini Point, like kayaking and canoeing.
And water tramp and the activity island. So the water tramp is like the giant trampoline with a blob, which is basically a balloon you jump on.
Yeah, and the activity island has got a swing and a lily pad that's really big, and it's really fun to play on.
Yeah, and you fall off a lot.
And they also have sailboats, really fun to go sailing on.
Yeah, well, you've never gone sailing on them, so I don't think you can really say that.
Well,
but
I have.
It's really awesome. So they're like 12-footers, and they're sunfishes, and a lot of them have really nasty bacteria in them, but they're still fun to sail.
Yeah.
And so they're fun to sail. Like, I did the sailing merit badge, which is awesome, but we'll more on that later. So
highly recommended.
Highly recommended.
Highly recommended.
Okay, next. I think we've done enough about that.
The second one is shooting sports. Aiden, you can go ahead and talk about this.
Okay, so it's like shooting sports / like throwing / like kind of like throwing sports. Because we didn't really have anything else to talk about. So shooting at sports. We have 22s. Shotguns, which I haven't shot yet, so I can't give you any information on that.
But 22s are pretty fun.
Yeah, so if you want more information about that, just, like, skip to the next video if you're watching it on YouTube. And don't, remember to like this one, too. Because that's always, you have to do that. And, that'll be talked about more. And, you'll hear more about this later.
They also have tomahawk throwing.
Oh, yes.
Which is really fun.
Okay.
You should really do that.
Okay.
And archery.
Archery, yes. That's
fun. That's a very fun thing, too.
Okay, next. Merit badges. Oh, wait. Food. Food.
Yes. We all need food, cheese, to survive, so.
Okay, one thing. Mini Point is really big into the whole granny bread thing.
Oh,
but
yeah.
I think it's a little overhyped. It's really, like, just bread, really. But, you'll hear more about granny bread later.
Yeah.
So, more people will rant on about that.
And, of course, merit badges, one of your favorite things to do at Mini Point.
Oh, yes, merit badges.
There's some
badges.
Really, really, really interesting
merit
badges.
They have, like, tons
here.
Of merit badges, yeah. They have, like, Dilshan did a wilderness survival one where he had to, like, survive in the wilderness overnight.
Yeah, that was really fun.
Yeah.
We all got bitten by mosquitoes, though. Oh, no.
Well, that guy has, like, little electric mosquito zapper.
Yeah. And you know how Aiden went sailing.
Oh, yes.
He had a lot of fun.
That was fun. You should do that. It's the best merit badge.
We also did wood carving.
Wood carving was awesome.
Yeah.
Except I didn't do it.
Yeah. Aiden's gonna try next time.
Okay. So, next. There are tons more. You should look.
Yeah.
Okay. I think that's about our time. So, if you're watching it on YouTube, like the video if you liked it.
Dislike it if you disliked it
and you didn't, and if you really hated it, express your feelings in the comments. And, if you really, really like the video, you can watch more.
Yeah,
but
it's really
interesting
video.
But I think ours is going to be the best. So, okay. Adios.
And up next is Henley and Vaughn with Granny Bread.
Granny Bread.
Thanks, guys. My name's Henley McNulty, and I got Vaughn Johnson here, and we're going to talk about Granny Bread.
Try Granny Bread. All new and improved look and taste. Try it with honey or jelly at the dining hall. It is great to eat as a treat.
It doesn't even cost a penny. All you have to do is bring your granny bread plate up to the counter, and she will give you some. You should just try it. It's great. Here's Zach and Charlie next with the Trading Post.
Thanks, Emily and Vaughn.
I'm Zach.
And I'm Charlie.
And we're going to tell you what they have at the Trading Post. Come on down to the Trading Post.
There are slushies with a variety of flavors, including blue raspberry, cherry, green apple, and strawberry kiwi for $2.
They also have various types of candies, such as the Three Musketeers, Skittles, Sour Skittles, Smoky Way, Reese's, and Snickers.
Also, come on by and get your merchandise.
So make sure to come down to the Trading Post during free time. And next up is Alex, Ben, and Ben for Beach Things.
Zach. Hi, my name is Ben Wilson. We are doing beach activities. Newcomb is a game you can play on the beach. So to start off, you have a volleyball, and you have each team on different sides of the net. So one team throws the ball over. If the other team misses it, they're out. If you catch it with one hand, that gets a team out, or teammate back in. If it doesn't go over the net, you're out. And if it exits the volleyball square, you're out. You can't spike the ball. If there is one person left, he says newcomb, throws the ball. If it gets someone out, whole team is back in. And once everyone is out on one team, the game is over. Also, when you play catch, when you catch the ball with one hand, you can't use your body. Otherwise, you won't be able to get teammate back in. This game is also good because you can play it at a lot of places. This is a really fun game you can play every day. Now, hand it over to Ben.
Thanks, Ben. I'm Ben Gachera, and I'll be talking to you guys about the Greasy Watermelon game. So, the Greasy Watermelon game is a game you play in the water, and there are two nets that are in a teepee shape, and you first grease the watermelon, and then you put the watermelon in the water, and then next your team puts your hands on the net, and then the watermelon is in the water, and the lifeguard blows his whistle. And after he blows his whistle, your team rushes to the watermelon. Then when your team gets the watermelon, you have to sing "I'm a Little Teacup," but anyone can sing it. That's what makes the game hard. And also, you can't see the watermelon underwater. So another reason is it's hard because someone might not have the watermelon, but you could say that someone does have it, even though they don't, and then everyone will go after them. And then they can score. And the game is really fun because you can play it with a lot of people, and it is in the water, so it cools you off on, like, hot days. And that's how you play it. Now we'll be handing it over to Alex.
Ben, and I'm going to be talking about Delta. It is a team-building activity near the beach. First, you line up without talking, starting from the oldest birthdays to the youngest. Then you sit down and talk about what you did good on and bad on. Then you get PVC pipes and a golf ball and line up to try to get it from a tree all the way to a bucket about 200 feet without dropping it. After that, you go to a thing called the witch finger. It is a piece of wood shaped like a lightning bolt. It has a tire and a rope attached to it, and you try to get the tire off of the post with your group. Delta is really fun. I like the PVC pipe the best. Next, we'll be playing a song called Shout. Please enjoy.
Well, you know you make me wanna shout, kick my heels up and shout, throw my hands up and shout, throw my head back and shout. Come on now, don't forget to say you will. Don't forget to say yeah.
Say you will.
Say it right now, baby.
Say you will.
Come on,
say you will.
Say it now.
feel alright.
Yeah, yeah, yeah,
yeah. Every time I think about you, you've been so good to me. You know you make me wanna lift my hands up and throw my hands back and kick my heels.
What a great song. I'm Sam.
And I'm Justin.
And we're here to bring you some things you need to remember when you're at Camp Many Point.
Remember to put on sunscreen or you'll get burnt.
Put on bug spray. Bugs bite.
Take at least one shower. You'll feel better as well as smell better.
Every day is different, so remember your schedule.
Remember the training post times, 8:45 through 11:45, 1 through 3:45, and 7 through 9.
Remember to have a buddy and remember where he is.
If you remember all these things, then you'll feel a lot better, and you'll smell less, and you'll get more things done.
Now here's Jack and Colton with things about Flintlock.
Hey guys, I'm Colton.
And I'm Jack.
And you're listening to Many Point Radio.
Now Colton, have you been to Flintlock?
Yeah, actually I've done just about everything in Flintlock.
Really? Wow, so out of all the activities at Flintlock, which ones are the best?
Well, I really enjoyed Huck Finn Overnight, where you start out canoeing out to a giant raft in the middle of the bay in the afternoon with all your friends. And then you'll eat out a delicious dinner and spend the night under the stars.
Sounds pretty cool.
Yeah, I had a great time at Flintlock and I would definitely recommend it to all the scouts looking for a little adventure.
Sweet. Last year at Many Point, I went on a Flintlock adventure myself. I spent the night at Treehouse Overnight. We boated out to the treehouses in the afternoon and went spar pole climbing and did an obstacle course. At night, we climbed up into the treehouses and had a campfire overlooking the lake.
That sounds sweet.
Flintlock does an awesome job with their high adventure programs.
Yeah, they do. I'm currently taking Water Sports Outpost.
What's that? I've never heard of Water Sports Outpost at Many Point before.
Well, we get to earn our personal watercraft permit so we can go out on the lakes and jet ski and boat.
Sounds like a great time.
Well, that's about it. I'm Colton.
And I'm Jack.
And that's Many Point Radio. Up next, we have Noah and Kyle on all Many Point activities.
Thanks, Colton.
I'm Kyle.
I'm Noah.
We're going to talk about some buckskin-wide activities. Firstly, we have the Ironman. You want to come test your skills Then come down to the beach on Tuesday to do a canoe, swimming, and running race, each 1 mile long, except swimming is just around the docks.
And then come down to the polar bear on Tuesday at 6:45 a.m. At the polar bear, it's going to be freezing cold at the lake. Perfect time to go jump in. So, if you want, it's just like the polar plunge, but even colder. Then, we have the beach bash on Wednesday at 7 o'clock. On the beach bash, we do many activities, like a gaga ball, and we also eat food, and we can't forget Big Jenga.
Next up is Nathan with Adventure Cove.
Thanks, Noah. I'm Nathan Kronbeck, and I'm going to tell you a little bit about Adventure Cove. It's a water activity that I recently went to this week. Here it goes. I'm Nathan Kronbeck, and I'm 13, and I'm from Troop 116. Today I will be telling you about my time at Adventure Cove. First off, it's a water activity, and it was really fun because there was this raft that you could go on and rock it around. The raft is called Saturn, and most of my friends could not get on it. But I forgot to put sunscreen on, so I got sunburn on my shoulders. If you go to Many Point, sign up for the Huck Finn, because there were two rafts that you could boat your stuff out to and sleep on them. Overall, Many Point was really fun, and now my friend Sam will tell you about his time.
Thank you, Sam. Now I'm Kyle with the Gaga Ball PSA. Are you ever bored during the summer? Are you a Boy Scout who loves to play amazingly fun games so you can use up an hour or two of free time instead of wasting it on useless activities like watching television or playing Xbox? If so, then you should go to Many Point Scout Camp. There are many, many fun games to play at this camp. In my opinion, I think Gaga Ball is the funnest game of all of the other great games you can play. First of all, in Gaga Ball, in order to win, you need to be the last person left in the ring of 8 sides. To be the last person, you have to eliminate the other players by getting them out, and by doing that, you get the Gaga Ball to hit them waist or below by doing whatever necessary. To start the game, you throw the Gaga Ball up in the air and let it bounce 3 times and say, "Ga, ga, ball," in the process. But you have to be back touching the wall until the third bounce. There are several other important rules in the game. One rule is that there is no scooping, which means you can't control the ball with your hands, that you can only bump the Gaga Ball. Another rule is that if you hit the ball too hard and it goes out of the arena, you are also out. One more rule is that you can't jump with the wall supporting you, so that you can't just sit on the wall. Each person can only hit the ball once every time it hits the wall or another player. If it comes to the final three, each person gets to hit the Gaga Ball twice. If there are only 2 people left, each person can hit the ball 3 times. The winner then gets the title Champion of the Universe until the next winner. This is one of the funnest games at camp, but there are other fun games, not quite, but close to as fun as this. Many Point Scout Camp is one of the best games I've ever been to for fun games. Many Point Scout Camp is awesome. Up next is Tyler, Addison, and Carl with merit badges.
Thanks, Kyle. This is Addison, and I am going to be talking about the camping merit badge. At camping, you learn about different kinds of tents, sleeping bags, and backpacks. You also get to go on a 4-mile hike to fulfill a requirement. On the hike, you visit one of the other campsites. Near the end of the week, we were tested on the principles of leave no trace. They are pick up trash, travel on durable surfaces, dispose of waste properly, leave what you find, minimize campfire impact, respect wildlife, and respect other campers. These can be easily remembered with the strange acronym, Pink Tires Dig Little Mice Racing Rabbits. It doesn't make much sense, but it does help remember. The final thing done at camping is planning a camping trip. Now to Carl.
Thanks, Addison. This is Carl. I'm going to be talking about the archery merit badge. In archery, you get to do lots of things archery-related, including making a bowstring with, of course, strings, making your own arrow, and shooting the bow and arrow. One of the requirements is hitting 170 points in 30 arrows on an 18-inch target, which every number is being 1.5 inches. The scores are 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. Next is Tyler.
Thanks, Carl. Hi, my name is Tyler. A couple of merit badges are radio, basketry, leatherwork, game design, and wood carving. For wood carving, we are doing a neckerchief slides right now. In game design, we are building games. In leatherwork, we are building a knife pouches, which is really fun. In basketry, we are building baskets. I'm going to be talking about wood carving. First, we had to buy a block of wood and a necky slide, and would carve the block of wood we wanted, and for the necky slide, carve all the black off it. For the wood, I did a tomahawk, and it looked like a Christmas tree. That's what most people think it looks like.
Thanks, Tyler. Okay, now Activity Island. Hello, my name is Ben. I'm from Troop 619. I will be talking about Activity Island. Activity Island has a rope swing, and you can do many activities on Activity Island. Like, you can swing on the rope, you can push someone off of it, you can also wrestle on it, and, you can also pull someone off too. You can dive and jump off of Activity Island. And now try tackling friends off it. That's all I have.
And now here's Luke and Ben with Akatramp and Activity Island.
Hi, my name is Luke from Troop 619. Today I'm going to be talking about Akatramp and why it's worth spending your free time going to. First off, let me explain what the Akatramp is. It is essentially a trampoline on the water. Said trampoline also includes the log and the blob. The log is a straight, round, long, and solid blow-up tube you can run on as a challenge to reach the end and even get back from without falling. The blob is a fairly cushiony blow-up figure that you can either attempt to crawl on to its end or get blasted off with the help of another person. This leads me to my next topic, which is why going to the Akatramp is even more worthwhile if you go with more people than just your required buddy. Swimming is always more fun with friends, but the Akatramp is even more so. This is because with a group you can play games like King of the Akatramp or competitions like who can make it farther on the log. This is the end of my broadcast, but the only way to decide if the Akatramp is fun is to go yourself. So find a friend or more, and head on down to the Buckskin Beach today. Now for our song, please enjoy Splish Splash.
Splish Splash, I was taking a bath, long about a Saturday night. Yeah. Rubbed up, just relaxing in the tub, thinking everything was alright. Well, I stepped out the tub, I put my feet on the floor, I wrapped the towel around me and I opened the door, and then a splish splash, back in the bath. Well, how was I to know there was a party going on? There was a splishing and a splashing, reeling with the feeling, moving and a grooving, rocking and a rolling. Hey, yeah! Bing bang, I saw the whole gang. Sue, good to golly, me.
Miss Molly was a even there to a willow. Splish splash, I forgot about the bath. I went and put my dancing shoes on. Yeah, I was a rolling and a strolling, feeling with the feel, moving and a grooving, splishing and a splashing.
That was a great song. Hi, my name is Jacob.
And Nolan.
And the Beach Bash is something to look forward to during the week.
It happens on Wednesday night and Tuesday. Oh no, it happens on Wednesday night and the staff have lots of activities planned for the campers.
There's also dinner served on the beach.
Hosted right in the middle of the week.
The timing is perfect. You get to eat and play games right at the beach. And when you are bored, you just leave and go back to your camp.
Although with Gaga Ball and much, much more, it's harder to get bored.
One of my favorite parts about it is that the adults get to go and have a meal separate from the scouts. It gives both the scouts and adults a break from each other.
Personally, I really liked it. It was one of the highlights of the week.
I'm Sam Herselt, and today I'll talk to you about ITSO. ITSO stands for International Target Shooting. This was probably my favorite thing at camp. What you do at ITSO is you get to shoot, throw and shoot a bunch of stuff. You get to shoot crossbows, longbows, you could also get to throw throwing knives, ninjas throwing things, and then other cool things like batarangs. My favorite thing there was probably throwing the batarang. I struck the target 3 times and got right my initials, so yeah, that was fun. Another thing I did was crossbow. I hit the target once, but who cares? So I suggest you go to it, and yeah.
All right, let's see some ID now.
AM 1610, KMPC Ponsford.
The station that reaches the beaches
and rocks the shores.